beautiful lady with the sign. Happy 17th wedding anniversary, sexy woman. Yes, you can sing with me. Is this your first show, dude? Is this not your first show? How old are you, man? How old are you? You're how old? You're 11? You look huge for 11. What's the song that you wanted to sing? Under pressure now. Hey? Cry me a river? Sure. Ready? Now you say you're lonely. You cry the whole night through. Well, you can
cry me a
river. I cried a river over you. Yes!
Oh, yes! Woo!
I gotta say, this is one of the coolest things I ever seen. This is so... Listen, firstly, I just want to say, even to... Hey, you, way over there. You didn't pay for these tickets. Oh, you better plug your ears. No, listen, I just want to say, I'm so happy to be here. This is so beautiful. 3 years I waited. 3 years for this. And over and over again, we postponed, we canceled, we postponed, and $1 million says, not all of you, but many of you, like the second time we, but you probably look at the internet and you say, like, asshole. I just want to say, thank you so much for your understanding. Thank you so much for your patience. It's, honest to God, it's emotional for me. I want to thank you so much for the money, too. I bought a bunch of these things behind you. They're so beautiful. This is where I'm going to stay for the summer. And thank you so much for just making me so rich. And I know that it's not everybody's cup of tea that we're here in Bath. And I know this because I took my kids yesterday for a walk. And this is, you know how sometimes stories, they're just real stories and you can't make them up? So I was right over there where those kind of people are there over there. And that the fence was down and the people were all looking at, they were building this place. And so I came over with my kids, you know. This is very posh tour happening. And when I walked up, this is the truth. The man said, yes, and so this absolute ponce Michael Bublé was showing up.
Love to
be honest with you, most of the time we get absolutely extraordinary photos and videos of the asshole that's shown up in his very face. It's the real God, and I said to him, I said, I'm that guy. And you know what he said? He said, if you give me a photo, I'll give you a tour. Ladies and gentlemen, I have waited for this, not just me. These beautiful women are the greatest musicians that your country gave birth to. These are the UK's own right here, these beautiful ladies on the strings. The rhythm section and the horns are all from America. We have come to show you what firepower is all about when nations come together.
Yes.
And the truth is, without you, there'd be no reason for us to be here. So I promise we are so grateful. We are so happy. Whatever you give us tonight, we will give you back 50 times fold. You got me?
Yeah, heck yeah.
Okay, that was okay. There's like 15,000 people and you sounded like the tour guide. Yes.
Tour guide.
We'll give you everything we have for this. Give it, let's go people, come with me.
Yes.
Yes. Michael, isn't just to put on an amazing show for you, it's to off the grumpy people who live here. Yeah, you didn't want to have a here. Too bad. We're here. We're here. I want to apologize. Speaking of that, I think, is it still Pride? I don't know if it's still Pride, but I haven't come out of the closet yet. I'm close. And to help me celebrate that, even though my wife and kids are watching me.
What?
I have a song, it's like YMCA, except it's like 100 years older. Get ready, get yourselves limbered up, okay? Get yourselves limbered up, because you're going to come here with me. Are y'all ready?
Yep, yeah.
What about you guys, are you ready? Let's do it. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. You know what? You guys are so lucky. You're so lucky tonight because you don't have so many stairs to go up over and over again. I was just thinking about it. This is the first time that I've had a stage like this. And the reason I came out and I said, how come there's so many stairs? I don't need no damn stairs. So many stairs. One, two, three stairs. And then they got a moat. Literally a moat that they built on purpose. And then no alligators, nothing like that. Just more steps for Buble man to do. Speaking of steps, I feel that some of you might have missed some steps in understanding who I am as an artist. So many of you, I know what you think. Think about holidays, you think about the old standards, you think Frank, Dean, Bing. But what people don't realize is that I'm also the world's greatest songwriter. So humble. Thank you. And they don't know that years ago I was in the shower, and that's weird, I know, but I wrote this song and I just thought it just makes me think of you. Because honestly, for the last 20 years of my life, there is nowhere else that I have felt more at home. So, ladies and gentlemen, in the greatest segue ever written in a show, this is yours. It's home. Let's do it. 9, 10, 11,
12, 13. Again with the steps.
14 stairs, 15 steps, 16 steps.
He's counting those 20, steps. 21. Okay, enough.
Let me go. Time to go home. Let me go home. It'll all be alright. I'm in Bath tonight.
Yes! Yes! Yes!
Yeah, I'm coming back home.
Listen,
there you go, right there. I'll put you right there.
Hold on, 1 second.
Can you see me from there?
Oh,
okay, you know what? I just figured all these people, they're all watching the show from there. Why not my mom? Why can't my mom watch for free?
Oh, really?
You're up. That's it. Okay, you'll be able to see me. What's funny right now is I know my mom so well, and part of her is thinking, and the other part she's thinking is, if anybody sees me, I'm, you know, do anybody like that here? Like, she FaceTimes me, but then refuses to show her face. You know what I'm talking about? Don't look at me, I'm just hideous. Anyway, this is another song that I wrote, by the way. It's with my mom and dad's house. And we were in the backyard, and I had one of those little cute little tape recorder thingy dingies. Remember the ones with the little tape recorder thing? Yeah. Am I old? But and I was about 16, and this is what came out of me. This was the chorus. See if you can recognize this, okay? It went, and when you sleep tonight, and while you're dreaming, I will know that dream come true. Cause when I sleep and when I dream of you. And that, at 25 years old, I rewrote and it turned into this. Said to me, hey Poppy, we wrote a song. And I said, okay, go for it. And they sang this little bit of a chorus. And I said, dudes, that's a good song. That's really good. And he said, yeah, Poppy. And months later, I was writing with a fellow named Ryan Tedder. Oh. You guys know Ryan Tedder, he's one of the great writers in America.
One Republic.
And it was going okay. And in the middle of the writing session, I kind of panicked. And I said, Ryan, my kids were singing this song in the shower. And his eyes got big. And he said, you know what, man? Okay, go for it. I sang it. We knew 35 minutes later we had a hit. It was incredible. It was weird how it happened, but I liked it so much. I named the record after it. I named this tour after it. And it's one of those songs that hasn't been released as a single yet, so some of you might not know it. I feel like Michael J. Fox of Back to the Future right now. You know? You may not know this, but your parents are going to love it. Yes, thank you so much, everybody. This is an old song that I wrote many years ago in Australia. By the way, I said whiskey. I'm a whiskey guy, not a vodka guy. It's not true. You guys know I would never work like that. It's wild. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you dig this. It was a request for tonight, so I'd like very much to make it for you. It's called Hold On. Let's do it.
Oh, I love this song. Crazy Love.
All right. I think it's about time to start the party. What do you say? Hey, wait. Before I do, is everything okay over there? No. I just mean that I've had 7 shows here in the UK. And out of all 7, I've had many, many pass out. Many. You okay, kid? Yeah, man.
I don't know what you just said.
You just tell me if she's okay. It's funny, you know, the third night, we had to stop the show over and over again. And this is the third time in a row that we had to stop it over and over again. And I came backstage, and I was distraught. My tour manager was back there, and I said to him, be honest with me, am I too sexy for this country? And he said, no. I said, no, I don't think it's that. And I said, okay, are they old? Was it old people? And he said, no, it's not that. They were young. One of the girls was 22, another girl was 27, and a girl was about 40. And I said, what's going on? He said, I think you need to go and tell the audience that they have a drinking problem. Well, you think I love you so much? Huh? Have you guys ever been to Canada?
I have.
You guys just know you're us with better vocabulary. She okay? I don't want to go until she's okay and we can get going and make sure that she has a room out of there. All right, listen. I'm not just going to be silent while this happens. So why don't I sing a nice slow song before we start the party? This is a great song. It's for everybody. It was written by an Englishman. It's the lyrics are written by an Englishman, set to an Irish melody, usually played with Scottish bagpipes. And my favorite singer ever was an African American that sang it. So this is just, it just gets everybody, you know? Would you give it to me, Roy? Oh, Danny boy, the pipes are calling.
I don't know this song.
From glen to glen and down the mountainside. The summer's gone and all the roses falling. Tis you, must go, and I must bide. But come ye back when summer's in the meadow, and all the valleys hush, and white with snow. If I'll be sunshine or in the shadow. Oh, Danny boy, oh, Danny boy, I love you so.
She's okay. She's okay. Are we ready to go?
Yes!
No, no, no. This time when I say, are you ready to go? You guys gotta go. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Are you ready to go?
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh.
Let's go. Can't you see, baby?
This is the true talent, and please help me in rewarding musicians who make this seem so simple, but they work their ass off every day, their whole life, to make it seem like it is. Ladies and gentlemen, the most incredible musos in the world. Give it up. Thank you. You know what's funny? You guys might think that I don't know,
You might think that I'm out of touch with reality, like most people like me are. Because they are. But I'm not. You think I don't know that so many of you got these as Christmas presents or birthday presents years ago? You think I don't know that so many of you traveled a long way, spent a ton of dough, had a huge pain in the ass getting here? How many of you work your ass off for the money that you make? And you chose to spend it with me?
Yes, I sure did as well.
I love you.
No, no.
I love you so much. Even you beautiful people back there. And you over there. I'm over there. You guys don't know. You know what's so cute? My tour manager, Dean, he just told me that the whole place around you is just packed. Just packed with people when you leave. So people, can I hear the people that aren't even here cheering? Holy shit. This is a really special night. I'm gonna be really honest with you. My promoters are here tonight. And for once I can say, this was my idea. 3 years ago, I said to them, let me go to my country and let me play in these places and have these magical nights. And with the sun shining and people dancing and drunk, and I think they thought I was nuts. And a night like this is the greatest night of our lives. This is unbelievable for us. Thank you so much. Let's do this again, huh?
Definitely, yes.
I love you guys. May God be good to you. I love you so much. Good night and thank you, everybody. Thank you so much.